In this video, I will show you how to easily thread a needle on a sewing machine. If you are interested in how to thread a needle for hand sewing, check out my other YouTube video. First, let's talk about some general rules to follow. Don't turn on your sewing machine while threading a needle if you are just learning to use your sewing machine, because you can accidentally start sewing and get injured. Have other sources of light around your sewing machine, so you won't need the light built in the machine. Some modern high-end sewing machines require you to turn it on for threading. My Destiny is one of them, because buttons will not work without electricity and threading is done automatically. But most sewing machines don't have this feature, so you better turn it off. Second, the thread should go from front to back through the needle and shouldn't be twisted. Third, raise the needle to the proper position. It's better if the needle is in the most up position. You can manually do it with a hand wheel. Of course, on modern computerized sewing machines, you can just press the up-down button to raise the needle, but for this your machine has to be turned on. Lower the presser foot, manually of course, or take it away completely. This way you will have more space to move around the needle. Lowering the presser foot bar will also engage the tension discs to keep the thread from pulling freely in your hands. If your vision is good and you have a vintage sewing machine or just a very simple one, you can thread a needle the regular way as our grandmothers did. Just make sure you cut the thread end with sharp scissors so the cut is clean and nice without any fibers coming apart. Licking the thread also helps. Hold the thread as close to the end as you can. Sometimes it takes me many tries to thread the needle this way. I need not only good eyesight, but also steady hands. There are plenty of small tricks to help you. For example, you can use a small piece of a white paper. Then you can see the needle eye clearly. Or use a headlamp to get some extra light and avoid shadows. Sometimes I'd borrow the headlight from my husband and use it to thread my serger. Tweezers are a very useful tool to pick up the thread end that comes through the needle. In some cases, it can be useful to unscrew the needle and thread it while it's not in the machine. It's actually quite easy to take the needle out and put it back already threaded. The modern world is full of helpful gadgets, and sewing world is not an exception. So there are special needle threaders for sewing machines which you can buy separately. Let me show you how to use one. There are two small arrows on it, so hold the thread horizontally, with either arrow facing up. Bring thread across the fork from side to side. Gently press the thread across the needle. Let go of the thread freely, don't hold it anymore with your fingers, and pull the thread down on the needle until you hear or feel a click. Push the thread. The small metal tongue will push the thread through the eye of the needle as it passes. You will see some loop behind the needle eye. Bring the rest of the thread with your hand or with tweezers. Here is another clip with close up and different angles. It's really very easy and fast. It takes longer to describe it than to do it. I have found that using this threader is invaluable. Modern computerized sewing machines have built-in threaders. Check if your machine has one. So small thing, but so helpful. Let's see how to use this threader. First of all, make sure your needle is in its highest position because the threader has to line up with the eye of the needle. You can do it manually with the hand wheel or push the needle up-down button, sometimes twice, if your machine has it. Hold the thread to the left of the needle. Draw the thread down around the threader guide or prong with some tension and bring it from left to right in front of the needle. Depress the threader knob down as far as it will go. You can see that a very small hook comes out through the needle eye from the back toward the front. Place the thread under the hook, keeping the thread parallel to the table. Release the threader knob slowly while holding the thread end with your hand. A loop of the thread will be pulled through the needle eye. Remove the loop from the threader and pull out the thread end through the needle eye. This built-in needle threader is a wonderful invention indeed, but you have to be gentle with it because it breaks quite easily. For example, if the small hook that goes through the needle eye is bent for some reason, it will go to the side of the needle rather than through the eye. In this case, you will have to center it again to realign it with the needle eye. You can gently push it back to the center position with your fingernail or a small screwdriver. Sometimes the hook fails to pull a loop of the thread. Something can be wrong. Then check the needle and its settings. Unfortunately, built-in needle threaders don't work well with thick threads, like size 10, 20, or 30 weight. They don't work with thin needles, sizes 65 and smaller, with twin needles. In this case, you will need to thread the needle the regular way. There are automatic needle threaders on modern sewing machines. My Destiny 2 has exactly that. See how wonderful it is. You practically just press a correct button for automatic threading. This feature is especially nice for machine embroidery when you need to change the thread color many times. Now the same procedure from a different angle. Now a few more clips about threading a needle on a sewing machine. Make sure the needle is threaded correctly. If the thread goes like this, you will not be able to sew. For this video, I used Eloflex thread. It's first ever stretchable thread for regular sewing machines. You can sew knits with it without a serger and use the thread in upper threading and in the bobbin. I have a review of this thread on my blog. Check links below this video. And now I want to show you something unusual. I bet you didn't see it before. What am I talking about? There are double eye needles now. They can be used to sew with two threads of different colors at once. They are for decorative use mostly, of course. Let's see how to thread this double eye needle. You can do it the regular way, as I'm showing in this video. But you can also use needle threaders. The one that comes with a sewing machine goes to the eye which is down, and the threader you buy separately goes to the upper eye. And here is an example of the decorative straight stitch made with the double needle. That's all for now. If you like this tutorial, share the video and leave a comment. I will be really grateful for this.